So the search engine is smart enough to check this stuff, and pretty much any market is competitive, guys. So if the market's competitive and Google grades everything, which, oops, both those are true, so all markets are competitive for just about any service out there, and then Google grades tons of stuff, then how is doing one thing going to help you that much? So if you're going to do one thing and you don't have money to spend to get started, then go off and buy a lead or do something like that. Don't waste money. I will tell you this, get a website up. Do have a website up, because it'll get tenure and trust, and you get a review every once in a while and stuff like this. I'm not saying you shouldn't try. I'm just saying be careful where you're putting it. And then I'll say this too, before I go off on what you should do besides just content. But if you're going to do this stuff, be careful saying you don't have money to market. I mean, if you don't have money to market, how are you going to have a business? So plan on marketing, work until you find something that works well, and then understand it well enough and make it part of your company mantra and thought process that I'm going to market and get calls and leads. Otherwise, how are you going to have a business? Hey there, it is Nolan Walker. I'm going to talk today about why you should not ask for content only. So we write content here, of course. And a lot of people talk about it and heard about it. You've heard words like content is king and all of this, but it's not the only thing that makes the site work. So let's talk about why. For one thing, I'll say from a fundamental standpoint, you know, most people don't go up to a professional service and say, you know, do it exactly like this. You go up for work and consulting, you hope they guide you in the right direction. So if you're going up to professional service providers and say, do this, but you're not the professional service provider, the chance of getting it done properly is very low. It's one thing to collaborate with someone or ask a question. It's another thing to say, hey, go do my taxes exactly like this, and don't do anything else. I want you to do that. And so you obviously would miss a lot of value and benefit from having the professional service. So if you're not someone is doing that. And I don't say that to belittle anyone or to make it sound that way. I say it to try to illustrate the point so you understand it. We've done this for going on a decade now and have dozens of people that do this. And I can tell you for sure that if you go on about doing content only or one thing only, it won't work well because the algorithm is grading so many things. So, okay, Nolan, if content isn't good enough, then what is it? Now, let me give you an analogy or a way to look at this is if you had a site that had great content but a bad design and everything else was bad, do you think that they would like it over one that was well done with also good content? Well, no, obviously. So the search engine is smart enough to check this stuff, and pretty much any market is competitive, guys. So if the market's competitive and Google grades everything, which, oops, both those are true, so all markets are competitive for just about any service out there, and then Google grades tons of stuff, then how is doing one thing going to help you that much? So if you're going to do one thing and you don't have money to spend to get started, then go off and buy a lead or do something like that. Don't waste money. I will tell you this, get a website up. Do have a website up, because it'll get tenure and trust, and you get a review every once in a while and stuff like this. I'm not saying you shouldn't try. Just saying be careful where you're putting it. And then I'll say this too, before I go off on what you should do besides just content. But if you're going to do this stuff, be careful saying you don't have money to market. I mean, if you don't have money to market, how are you going to have a business? So plan on marketing, work until you find something that works well, and then understand it well enough and make it part of your company mantra and thought process that I'm going to market and get calls and leads. Otherwise, how are you going to have a business? So respect marketing enough to spend money on it as you have it and make it a priority. So let's talk about it. So Google's going to grade design, and a custom design's better than a template. Why? Because the code base in there, if you hire somebody smart enough to do this work properly, the code base tells them how to parcel data. What do you think Google likes about parceling data? Well, it's important to them. They can tell with schema code where everything is. More specifically, they can trust the data better, semantic markup and structured URLs and siloed architecture and all that. It helps guys a lot. Structuring URLs alone, they show up in search rankings. If they're structured like gobbledygook WordPress jargon, you're going to lose points on that or not get points or even get penalized from the search engines based on that alone. The content is important. It is very important. And it's over talked about. It's over, but every year it gets more serious, meaning it has to be so well done, so well written, structured, and it just needs to be fantastic. Deep dive content, you can't have cruddy city pages. You got duplicate content, it's bad. You got shallow content, it's bad. You got copied content, it's bad. You got a bunch of junk pages up just to get you a click, like all these little city pages, that's bad too. So there's tons of stuff I've done on this, and you can go into it a little bit more, but you don't want to have content just up to have content. It's got to be great. So you're going to focus on where you are. A lot of this stuff, if it's local, you focus locally. If it's national, it's got to be fantastic content. Somebody knows what they're doing. Blogging, additional, adding content, changing content, blogging, yes, it's also important. Stuff can't just go stagnant. So they're grading not just content, but design, code-based content, blogging, citations. If you're local, that's your listing around the web. It helps provide continuity of NAP and other enhancement of NAP, which is name, address, phone number, and it helps enhance your brand. All this stuff begins to tie in together and Google feels more comfortable. They can read code, they can read the content, read by the code, they can see changing stuff, it's deep dive, it's custom. Citations and other websites list you the same way. It strengthens the brand, which of course increases your organic rankings, map placement, things like that. Domain authority. It's basically inbound linking, but oops, you better be stupid careful about this one because they'll ban the site. Remember the Penguin algorithm of 2012 and 13. So you do need inbound linking. A citation's an inbound link, but you need a little more and it's got to be done well. And if your domain authority is in the gutter, like really low, like under 20, you can go online and do free domain authority checker. And if you're a local company and you're not in the 20s in a competitive market, you're going to have a really hard time showing up at all. Most locals won't get to 30, but 25 to 30, getting closer to 30 is a really strong company. And if you're national or regional, it better be higher than that or you probably won't show up. Google My Business, GMB, needs to be tended to. Videos, posts, pics, regular work, got to be done. So GMB account, getting tended to. Reviews around the web, not just Google reviews, but reviews from multiple places. They've got to be integrated, changing. Social media, regular work, competition. So I hope that makes the point well. So if you call up and you ask for one thing, well, we can't help you because you're going to fail at that anyway. So one thing I call one trick pony deals, they don't work anymore. You need all this stuff to happen. And guys, it is less expensive than you think. We're much, much better deal than you normally find out there for the level of services that we have. And when I talk about level of services, you have to have the very best because everything's so competitive. So there's no half-stepping. Anything under the best services you can find is complete trash work out there. I know that most of you know this because you've had complete trash work all the time. So you have some social media presence and something going on, and regular work of a lot of this stuff is going on constantly. Like weekly, monthly stuff is getting done. And I guess I talked about competition here because it's like, okay, if it's a horse race, which it is, your competition, and Google grades you and uses all this stuff for signals, it's like, okay, Nolan, that makes sense. I can see how I need all this stuff to happen. So guys, I am empathetic to starting. I get that. I started as a small service company so many years ago and then built and built and built and built. But I've reinvested my money into myself, my business, my marketing. So as you grow, do acquire excellent services such as ours. And don't not call just because we do a lot of this stuff for under $1,000 on local, depending, and depends on what all you have. But if you're looking to get started, do start, do get something going, but you need all of it. So hope you enjoyed it, and we look forward to hearing from you someday.